Yeah, I mean, for the most part, the clients that I've been bringing in have been just blessed with sometimes even the making of those couple of topics is still kind of like the description that is from me. I don't consider myself an expert in branding and marketing, but one thing I know is that you love it. So excited. And I'm not, you know, when I get excited about something, I tend to pour myself a program for every popular, you know, marketing collateral that goes in all the branding groups and just devour it all. Because I just like the idea of how it encapsulates in some way someone's message or mission and how to make them spend it. Try to get them out there and package it a little bit. That just feels absolutely wonderful. Sometimes you're helping somebody to really identify their own vision. One personal friend who's very, very talented, Jeff Seaver, is a fighting I think, I knew him, but I didn't know he was quite as famous as he was. And one competitor was taking this New York Magazine top 100 doctor, driving clinical psychiatric practice in New York, teaching hospital at Mount Sinai. A couple of thousands of research papers under this guy. I mean, this guy is very, very good at what he does. But he also happens to be a world-class juggler. The juggling psychologist. Anyway, he teaches workshops that teach not just medical professionals, but anybody who's interested. For a long time, I was focused on conversions, people in the world, people who are interested in the VA, operations, and how to be needed. Right, but he teaches it all through the means of struggle, which is really fascinating. And he's world class, and he won a gold medal in one of the sports that he wrote to struggle. And so, coming up with his whole approach was that he's read all the cultural things done, which I think is when you have seven objects fully visible outside of your hand, something that you're not holding to with five and you're reflecting on the other. And so that became his brand, was quite interesting. And it was just absolutely exciting to get involved in all that. But one of the things we discovered, he discovered and told me about, was that juggling is one of those behaviors or skills that most people assume that they cannot be taught how to do. And yet the malleability of the central cortex and the fact that you've got unallocated cells in your brain that can be trained in an amazing way as well as later. And he proved it. He showed that juggling can be learned by people at any age. And that he worked out and worked with a couple of hundred people of all of them. He ends up slightly weighted handkerchief, so it slows the hit down. And by the end, virtually everybody in the place has learned this skill just to be able to juggle. So he proved to all of them that there's tremendous skills for being learned. You were positive when you walked in here and you could not do it. And you're positive when you walked out of here and you absolutely never did it. And in fact, I think it was a science magazine that showed in it was touch scans that there's some kind of highlighted brain scan what had happened to photographic and flesh process human brains before and after it was in trouble. And they were like all lit up like Christmas trees and all these bright yellow and black red spots showing like what I thought was kind of serious images.